Hello, hello, everybody. It is 9:53 a.m. Central Time on the 15th of November, 2018, and we are here on the Earthquake 3D live stream to talk about seismic events that have happened. And you're seeing the background here down at the bottom of my hill. Just had about 7 inches of snow since last night. Still going on right now. And we're waiting for it to wrap up so I can go out and do some wonderful shoveling. Well, that being said, let's go dive into the deep end on earthquakes. What's happened since last night? And I've got some news for you, too, that we need to jump into on top of the earthquake. So really quick, let's recap what's happened. A new deep earthquake right in the middle of our letter D. And letter D stands for deep earthquakes. It's coming in at 567 kilometers deep, which means we need to add on at least 1.1 up to 1.2 magnitude, which takes us up to 5.8 potential just off this deep earthquake alone. And there's been a series of deep earthquakes here in the last several days, going down to 600-something kilometers deep. So there's even deeper earthquakes than the one that just hit. So far, no follow-up larger movement yet. The longer we go, the bigger it's going to get. Right now, we're looking for 6.2 to 6.3 to be coming up here, next to the deep quakes. But like I said, the longer we go, the bigger it's going to get. Going across the West Pacific since last night, nothing. So nothing in the West Pacific since last night. Yeah, that's not normal. And then going across all of Asia, nothing over in China again. But look what happened. In the most ironic twist of fate in the world, as if somebody was watching our update last night, issued a memorandum or memo to the people around the USGS. Next thing you know, we get an earthquake reported out here in the middle of Mother Russia. Up here in the Ural Mountains, Special Agent dutchsinse, mission accomplished. Let's get the information and put it in. Go look it up and see what's there. Well, you know, it's always good. Spasiba, ochen herosha. Please, 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 to be clearing from street. We have emergency. Do not be scared. Be prepared. Okay, here we go. Where are we? We're in the Ural Mountains. Where is this? Yuri Yuzan? My middle name's Yuri. I'm not joking. I have my own Istan? Is this Yuri Istan? Gotta be kidding me. Oh my goodness. Oh my. It doesn't get any better than this. How you couldn't ask for it. You couldn't write a book any better than this. You couldn't write a movie any better than this. Yuristan or whatever. Oh. Yeah, nobody's watching my updates. It's just a coincidence. It's just a coincidence that they put an earthquake here after not reporting any earthquakes in Russia in God knows how many months. We call them out yesterday for not reporting them. When they do, they put it on at Yuristan? Oh, yeah, okay. Let's go over to the West. Oh, man, somebody's got a good sense of humor. Or it's the biggest coincidence in the world, in which case God's got a great sense of humor. Either or both. All right, down in South Europe, how about a new 5.0 earthquake? It was 5.3, but look who got their hands on it. The USGS got their hands on it. And what did it become? It became a 4.9, just like all the other fives. So, was it a 5.3 or was it a 4.9? Well, if you believe statistically in this number of 4.9 earthquakes, I guess you should be buying that bridge in Brooklyn that's for sale that I heard about on Craigslist. All you gotta do is drop a few hundred grand cash and they'll mail you the title. But you can just go right to New York, set up a little booth right on the bridge, put two drawbridges on either side, or gates, and start charging a huge toll to go across over into New York. You'll make millions, from what I read on Craigslist, you know. Now let's look across the rest of South Europe. We have the earthquakes from last night taking place here in central Italy, but nothing new today, any significant size. Now look where all the rings overlap. This is where we have our warning going for something in the mid-range to upper 5 to strike. This is so close. This is on your doorstep. And to get a new 5.3 last night, right down here, why does it matter if it's a 5.3 or a 4.9? Do you guys know why a 5.3 matters? Remember what they hid out here in Russia yesterday, the 5.3. And the day before, they hid the 5.3 down here in Mongolia at China's border. So they hid two sets of 5.3s, then a 5.3 hits down here and they change it to a 4.9. It's troubling. They do it enough that it's suspicious. Looking into South America, we get into the north and south part of Chile, actually north and central Chile, with two of the same size quakes, 4.0, 4.1, and after last night's 5.0 down here at the South Sandwich Islands. By the way, USGS, guess what they have it at, or had it at, 4.9. Going across Central America, they took this 4.9 from yesterday down to a 4.8. You know, because, again, I know they're listening to the updates, but they had it at 4.9 last night. Now they took it down to a 4.8. It's coming in right next to Costa Rica, and Costa Rica has been seeing a series of earthquakes after our eruptions happening at Turrialba. Let's go consult the Volcanic Ash Advisory Center, see who's on the list for today. Reventador in Ecuador, Sabancaya in Peru, Cochina Arabijima in Japan, Ducono in Indonesia, Reventador, Sanjay Fuego in Guatemala. Oh, who else is on the list? Catovar, Reventador, Sabancaya, Krakatau, blah, blah, blah. Same volcanoes over and over again. Man, it's just like yesterday. So it's a pretty long list going into yesterday. Yesterday's list was extremely long, but today's list so far, and not exactly terrible, but it is only 10 a.m. my time, Central Time. Okay, well, we've got something else we need to talk about here. We need to go all the way over here towards Africa. And that's the whole point of me making this video, actually, is to go into this news. And the news that I'm getting ready to bring to you, I want to thank a few people in chat. I want to say thanks to Eddie, who dropped this information on me like a ton of bricks. And it hit me like a ton of bricks. And I really had a little bit of a meltdown as I was sitting there on my laptop upstairs. And I said, I'm going downstairs to make a video and talk about this because this really, really, really bothers me. All right, so you ready? I'm not going to rant too hard. Instead, I'm just going to show you what the news is. So we're going to go over here. We're search Mayotte, M-A-Y-O-T-T-E, Volcano Island. And you'll get a story released 19 hours ago. Coming from Strange Sounds, one of the only people to actually pick it up, aside from the actual science agencies. And this is in French, in case you want to go read it. The press release that's been issued here, talking about Mayotte Island. I'll read it to you. Listen to the headline. There was a new volcanic island emerging near Mayotte, and this new hotspot could be the reason behind the earthquake swarm rattling the island since May 2018. Since May 2018, the island of Mayotte has been... May was misspelled, by the way. Well, that's foreign spelling. Okay. Since May 2018, the island of Mayotte has been rattled by hundreds of earthquakes. The latest hit on November 7, 2018. Meanwhile, scientists think they have found what's behind the seismic series in the Indian Ocean. According to them, a new volcanic island is emerging from below. After continuously analyzing data from the four permanent GPS stations on the island of Mayotte, scientists from the National Institute of Geophysical and Forest Information, IGN, have recently suggested that the seismic unrest rattling the area is due to a new volcanic island emerging from underwater. Since July of 2018, scientists have noted all of the four GPS stations on Mayotte had slightly moved about 50 millimeters to the east and 25 millimeters south, moving east and south. According to them, this movement shows the new hotspot forming off Mayotte in the Indian Ocean. This movement shows that a new hotspot is forming off the Indian Ocean. If confirmed, this would probably lead to the apparition of a new volcanic island about 50 kilometers from the coast in the years to come. And here is their information. You can see it all here. Seismo Steve's got it all. And, well, okay. Well, now you guys are welcome to go on and read it. You can go over to their Twitter page or Facebook page. So this is the prefecture or prefet de Mayotte. This is them. Now, why does this matter? Well, we have to go back to when the earthquake swarm started here at Mayotte Island. Let me show you where Mayotte is and why it matters. Here is Madagascar. And let's look at our map here. See the big arrow? Big arrow pointing in. This is the way the earthquakes move, coming out of Indonesia and go across over to our letter X in South Africa or Southern Africa. And the big arrow goes right across, right where Mayotte Island is. Mayotte Island hasn't erupted in 3,000 or more years. So we're looking at a, you know, long, long time ago. Last eruption, 2050 BC, plus or minus 500 years. So 2,500 years ago is the last supposed eruption at this location. And the earthquakes struck and started to strike over here off the eastern side of Mayotte Island. When that happened, and I looked up and saw that it was an ancient volcano that hasn't erupted in thousands of years, I made video after video talking about it and talking about the potential that this is some kind of volcanism taking place. I was mocked, ridiculed, people made videos. There's even a guy from NASA who made a video calling me out saying that there was no connection to volcanism at this location and that they literally mocked and ridiculed me. I've got the video saved, so don't bother deleting it, guys. And we're going to be talking about that later because all I was doing was showing the earthquake striking next to an ancient volcano and venturing out there that if you get an earthquake swarm, numbering in hundreds of noteworthy-sized earthquakes, going up to 5.0 and a bunch of 4s and 3s and 2s and 1s and 0s, all striking here east of the island, well, you're going to have to start to piece it together. Instead of going into denial mode and make fun of dutchsinse mode, what should have happened, and apparently what did happen, was this. Studies were done. Instead of denying and going into total shutdown freakout mode like everybody does online, these people went and actually studied. And it's the people who apparently, now you got to remember what happened to me. Somebody contacted the State Department, apparently. My channel got shut down. You guys remember this is in the middle of the summer. You guys remember this. It got shut down for 2 days. It was a big deal. And everybody told me, well, you know, maybe they got a problem with what you're doing. You know, you're causing such a stink for them. And I wasn't causing any problem for anybody. All I was doing was showing the earthquakes, zooming in on Google Earth, and showing that it was an ancient volcano, and said, if the swarm keeps on there, we're going to assume that it's some kind of volcanism at play. Now it is confirmed. Confirmed. And not only that, the island moved. The island physically shifted in the opposite direction than the earthquakes move. Go figure. Just like all our other spots on the planet. Earthquakes move one way, actual physical movement at the surface goes the other. I think it's a conveyor belt type action, where the earthquakes are happening down below, moving in one way, and the surface is moving on the other. So the underside of the conveyor belt moving differently than the top side, in the opposite direction. Right? So that's the amazing part on this. And when I get proved like this, again, we can go back on to my YouTube channel and go back to the middle of the summer. Let's do that, actually. Let's go. Well, I mean, gosh, how long is that going to take? Go back through my old videos. We have to go back 6 months worth of videos. But we could do it. Go back to the middle of summer and find our Mayotte Island videos. Yeah, this will take a long time. Look, you go down to 2 scrolls. I'm back to August. Yeah, okay, here we go. We can get back here. Oh, this is when all the volcanoes were erupting, too. Ah, oh, look where it cuts off. Look at that. It won't scroll down past 722. Look, it just stops. Are you kidding me? Hold on. 722, it just stops and won't let people view beyond 722. What the heck? Hold on. Let me hit refresh. Oh man, this is censorship right here, guys. This is censorship. Let's scroll down again. 722. You gotta be kidding me. Oh, it stops at 722? You gotta be kidding me. Oh my god. Okay. Well, I'm gonna prove to you that I've got all my videos up in public. Oh my god. They are censoring me. You've gotta be kidding me. Well, hold on. Make sure I don't show any personal information on here. Who knows what the creator studio shows? I don't ever go in the back end here. Oh, okay, you can see it. Okay, never mind. Not that big of a deal. All right, so this is what, when you log into your back end, if you click on creator, I never go in here. But, so, you know, total number of subscribers, total channel views, la-da-da-da-da-da. Let's go over to my video manager. All right, all public. Now we're going to go, let's go to like page 4. So it stops on 722, eh? 722. That is insane. Blocking my channel from getting viewed, man. No wonder it's dying out. No wonder I'm not getting views on the videos. You can't go back and scroll through. Man, unbelievable. Okay, here's where it cuts off for them, right? Okay, so they cut it off on 722. Look at where they cut it off. They cut it off right before this video here. Earthquake unrest obvious. Multiple 5.0 and 6.0 events. Iran hit while live. Oh, man. That's just bothering me. All right. Here. USGS publicly disparages me on Twitter. Now, we need to go back to May. Let's go back to May. All right. Maybe two more pages. I can't believe they're blocking me like that, man. No wonder my videos have dropped off to 10,000 views. They're blocking the videos. They're not letting me even be seen. You can't even get the videos. Ah, here's where the USGS was writing emails about me to people. USGS Public Relations, USGS Customer Service, writing out emails disparaging me personally to my viewers. People wrote them asking questions about my videos, and they wrote back just dissing me hard. What I'm trying to find is the Mayotte Island where I was talking about it, and I don't know if I'll find it here. I guess I could go search Mayotte. Ah, there we are. Mayotte volcanic set to erupt after 5,000 years. There we go. Here's the video right here. Let's go over and check it out. Since it's blocked, let's go share it. Let's go share it on Twitter. Twitter, tweet. Now it is proved. But back in May, they mocked me for saying it was even possible. Go figure. Yep. How about those apples, guys? And that they have to go that hard to try and hide and to stop what I'm doing. Okay? That is just... Let's go see the most recent comment. When was the last time somebody commented on this? 5 months ago was the last time somebody commented on it. Oh, boy. Look at this. Look at this person. Whatever, Dutch. I'm ashamed of your lack of integrity. Shut up! Shut up, dude. I got proved right. I was looking out for the people at Mayotte. Hundreds of thousands of people. While you were there denying on a YouTube video, I was trying to save lives. What were you doing? You're trying to make a name for yourself in chat room somewhere. Ooh. You're a big, big online name for yourself. Oh, hey, new 4.0 earthquake struck up here. Just elevated, actually. They upgraded the earthquake to 4.0. This strikes next to Sulphur Peak. Sulphur Peak in southeast Idaho, right where that mystery shaking happened the other day. So the mystery shaking happened just the other day. Now we got a new 4.0 earthquake. Well, it's 4 days beyond what we were looking for. We were looking for that four to come in about 4 days ago. So it's taken that much longer. Amazing. Well, I've taken the time to prove to you that a few things that I've talked about over many, many months have now been proved. I am a controversial figure online, but only because I propose things that fly in the face of what professionals say and what textbooks used to say. Textbooks are wrong on many things. Always have been and always will be. They're constantly changing them all the time. Wiping out whole sections of textbooks, rewriting them, and sometimes totally omitting them and dropping them. Other times, adding whole bunches to the studies that are found. In other words, science is always changing. It's not static. There's only a few things that are static, like laws. So if you have a law, okay, a law is going to be something that becomes almost virtually impossible to unseat in science. Anything that's not a law is exactly just that. It is something that's not a law, which means it's questionable, it's something that can be turned on its head, it's something that can be completely debunked, even if it's currently accepted. That's why I don't trust much peer review. You know, peer review said that we had a solid ball of metal at the core of the Earth. Now they just found out, go figure, in the past 2 months, that it's much softer than expected, that it's actually soft, not hard, and that it's not a full ball of metal either. They don't exactly know what it is, guys. So, while they're trying to figure that out, all that peer review that said solid ball of metal, well, it was reflecting like a solid, sure was. Sure was reflecting like it was a solid. Now they have new creative explanations they're trying to come up with to explain this new soft core. Well, soft core, Well, that means peer review's bunk. It just means peer review just verifies that it's in line with what current accepted ideas are. That's it. That's it. That's the only reason they make you do it, is because they try to make it all fit. And if they can't, they throw it out. Or they reject it, make it really hard for you to get it even published anywhere, because they don't want to deal with any rejections or conflicting information that debunks any other previously peer-reviewed subjects. So it becomes a crescendo of baloney from the professionals. And meanwhile, while they're all denying the obvious, like this, an earthquake swarm striking next to a volcano that hasn't erupted in 3,000 years, and it goes on and on and on and on and on, means volcano coming back to life. That's what it means. We don't go into spin mode. We don't go into deny dutchsinse mode, trying to fake earthquakes to make it look like Mayotte Island is erupting. That's the realm of a small mind. Right? You're coming up with creative explanations to explain why you don't want to believe something. Like I would give two craps about some island I've never heard about before. Okay, so word up to all my viewers who've taken the time to share the information, I've done my best. I have never made one thing up, have never faked anything. I stand by that till the day I die. You may not agree with my conclusions, but that's just it. You don't agree with my conclusions. I've never faked anything, I've never frauded anybody, I've never taken anything from anybody, I've never done anything wrong when it comes to online. Now, of course, in my life, you know, come on, we've all done all kinds of things, but not related to science. And I'll tell you what, guys, I have tried my best to present everything that I've talked about, even the controversial stuff, like HARP and Core of the Earth and other things that I present that are controversial, that I try to find as much information and I change my beliefs based upon what I find. I mean, geez, they still call me a Sandy Hooker, right? Sandy Hooker, even after I have told the people from there that I think that I wish them well and much love for the loss of their loved ones and all kinds of stuff. That doesn't matter to people. You're not allowed to change your ideas. You're not allowed to have any various ideas that are outside of the norm. And if you are, you're publicly crucified. Well, now, what do you got to say about this one, guys? Sure sounds like this one is a lot like the fracking earthquakes that were denied over here in the United States. I was mocked and ridiculed in 2010 and 2011 for saying drill points at fracking operations were leading to earthquakes. Then the largest earthquakes in the continental United States Midwest hit in years, and they were all at pumping operations. The USGS had to correct themselves. They had to issue public statements that fully contradicted everything they had on their websites no more than a few months before, and years going up to it. While I was mocked and ridiculed for showing the pumping operations getting hit, they all had to come back out and admit they were wrong, but they didn't admit they were wrong. They just took the stuff off their websites and reprinted it and moved on. And basically just tried to put it under the rug and tried to pretend like they were always on board with fracking earthquakes. This is 1984 George Orwell, where we were always enemy with Eurasia, and now we're always friends with Eurasia at the stroke of a pen. Okay, now, one more time, if you're just now getting up to speed on what's going on, I've been confirmed on something that I was very controversial. A 3,000-year-old volcano here is now putting off a new undersea mount on the side of it at Mayotte Island, leading to big swarms of earthquakes there and stopping the flow going over into southern Africa, and it still hasn't resumed. So the flow into southern Africa has not resumed. Mayotte Island is still blocking it, and it even got hit this past week. And it's coming in from where? It's coming in from Indonesia, going across the Indian Ocean. So our most recent quake just 3 days ago, coming across over to Mayotte. Just blows my mind to see that happen. Do you guys like what I do? If you want to support what I do and support more research where I fly in the face of what the professionals say and apparently stick up hornet's nest worth of trolls online and do all this stuff, if you like what I do, you can subscribe. You can come over to Twitch or go over to YouTube, either or. Let's go over to YouTube first. Please feel free to subscribe. I would appreciate it. 290,220. We're trying to get this up above 300,000 and then up to 1,000,000. And then up to 10 million. Well, I don't know if that'll ever happen. I guess that would mean somebody would have to acknowledge what I'm doing and stop denying it. Look, lives are at stake at this point. I'm going to keep going regardless. If you're stopping me or you're trying to stop it, I would say it's on you at this point. I'm doing my best to try and get it out there. If you're trying to stop it, the lives that are lost from not getting the warning would be on you, wouldn't it? If there were potential lives to be saved. You might not agree that there's lives to be saved. In which case, you wouldn't think that you were responsible for somebody not getting a warning then. But I don't think that. I think that you would be responsible for stopping somebody getting a warning, which then could, theoretically, stop them from being prepared. And if an earthquake hits, that would mean you would be responsible for them not being prepared. I just don't see why you would want to do that when you could easily admit a few things, such as, I've been right on fracking earthquakes, I've been right on Mayotte Island, I've been right on many different things. I don't get the credit for it because people don't want to admit I'm right on anything because that would then lend credence to what they want to deny. And we all know they're denying something that's observed, a progression of earthquakes across plates. So if you like what I do, please subscribe. I would really appreciate it. Let's go over to Twitch and say hi to everybody over on Twitch. Love it, whether you're on YouTube or on Twitch, you guys have...
Does this make you
want... Ooh, that makes me want to have a Reese's Pieces. Let's get a Reese's Pieces. Let's make a dutchsinse shirt that looks like that. Okay. Speaking of dutchsinse shirts, if you want to financially support my operation, there's two ways to do it. One, over on Twitch, you can become a subscriber. The other is to buy a dutchsinse item. We have zipper hoodies. Here's our winter version. This is our winter zipper hoodie. The fall winter 2018 has the dutchsinse logo on the front, and on the back says dutchsinse. Pretty basic, pretty cool. It also comes in gray and white. So if you guys want to get one of those, we also have other things like stickers. Hey, come on, the Dutch Drapers Guild. Look at it. Look at these guys. You've seen them before. Famous painting, Rembrandt, I think. Is that Rembrandt? It might not be Rembrandt. But the Dutch Drapers Guild, and that's a sticker. It's a high glossy for bumper sticker style, so pretty cool stuff if you want to get one of those. Finally, there is one final way you can support the operation, and that is to actually get dutchsinse coffee. So we have a sponsor, if you will, or somebody who's going to be helping us, and that's the Great Escape Coffee Company. So greatescapecoffee.com, and you'll find the dutchsinse blend here. Good vibes blend, roasted with much love. And I am drinking some of that right now. Hold on. Ooh, still so good. As I look out to 7 inches of snow out here, and yeah, fun stuff. I got to go shovel a driveway as soon as it stops snowing. So let's just hope it snows all day and I don't have to go shovel till tomorrow. Yeah, this is where my invention comes in real handy at this point. What invention, Dutch? Oh, don't worry. They'll all say it won't work. Oh, wait, you mean it's just projecting a heat lamp down a mirrored tube onto your driveway so you can melt the snow on your driveway? Oh, just a powerful heat lamp down a mirrored tube? Oh, that'll work. Okay, you can't say that one won't work. It's a good idea. Hey, imagine it this way. A PVC pipe mirrored on the inside, and a very powerful heat lamp at one end, and a projector lens at the other. And the projector lens projects out the heat lamp out onto your driveway and keeps your driveway somewhat melted. Or you project it onto your car, and it melts the thing on your car. You keep it about 10 feet away, put it right above your car, shine the light on it. Hey, they should put those on bridges and on roads too, don't you think? Ah, well, that would be too much common sense. Much love, guys. I'm going to save this as a video over on YouTube, and we're going to put this one out over on YouTube. I'm going to title it Proved Right or Vindicated or something like that. We'll put in the title to get everybody's attention. Vindicated. 3,000-year-old volcano comes to life. One of my more controversial things that I said, actually, in the past year. There's only a few really controversial things that I said. One of the controversial things that I said was that this 3,000-year-old volcano was coming back to life after the earthquake swarm started to strike there and didn't move from Mayotte Island. Okay, so this is why you got to stick to your guns. This is why you've got to go and do the research in the face of all the professionals and all the talking heads and all the know-it-alls who really only know what they're told to know, which really means they don't know much. They're good parrots, but that's about it. They can repeat back to you a book and memorize it perfectly. But when it comes to making discoveries, they're not very good at it. It's kind of like the USGS. They're great at calculating earthquakes, reporting earthquakes, calibrating a station, giving you a technical answer on this or that. But when it comes to doing research and discovery, they totally suck. They're obstinate. Backwoods. Okay, that's where they are. It's okay. You have to admit it. They're good at reporting. They suck at discovery. Just in general, the USGS is, as a whole, and the people tied to them, the professors, the students, they're all great at learning what other people discover. They're not great at discovering things themselves. And I'm not saying that to be rude or mean or egotistical or anything. I'm just being honest. Name me the last great discovery the USGS made. No, they're always repeating everybody else's great discoveries. The ones that they want to accept that, well, that fit with what they've said previously. That's not very good, is it? I don't think so. I'm not impressed by it. Not going to impress me, and that's what this whole thing's about, isn't it? You're not going to change my mind. So, and the people's minds aren't going to be changed. I mean, are they going to get up and speak with confidence about what they believe in? Hell no. They're too scared to even talk about what's going on, let alone what they think. Well, that's where we got them cornered. You guys have a good morning, afternoon, evening, or night. It is 10:27 a.m. Central Time. Peace out. Oh, and I'll see you back over on YouTube when this premieres.